So you can think of excitability as being something that's naturally important for the memory formation process. Before receiving any stimulation at all, their level of activity is shown by this bar right here. And then after receiving stimulation, it increases substantially, actually kicking it over into the positive realm. There are a million steps between a basic science study like this one and an actual clinical intervention, but at least it indicates that it's worth going down that path. You know, someone comes into the lab and we use an MRI scan taken before they receive any brain stimulation in order to identify the hippocampal memory network so that we can then aim our TMS procedure at it. So the camera that's monitoring the room is recording the subject's head position and the TMS wand position in real time so that we can know exactly where we're delivering stimulation into the subject's brain. So we process their MRI data, identify a stimulation target within their hippocampal memory network, and then that target gets stimulated consecutively for 5 days in this particular study. For each day they come in, we use what's called a stereotactic reference frame to localize the position of their head in space to their MRI. That way we can deliver TMS to an area of their brain and we can verify that location by knowing the position of their head relative to their MRI scan, essentially.
Each of these will be paired with 6 other objects, and your job is to try to remember which object is paired with this scene.
Essentially, every single day that we tested them in the experiment, subjects would play the memory game, where they would have to remember that a picture went at a particular spot, or they would have to remember that two pictures went together. And that's what we would test them for. And what stimulation did was it improved their performance.